Hey everyone, Grant here for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, we'll discuss how you can share your Flames product media with other applications within your facility. This can be a necessity when your pipeline requires some form of collaboration, such as VFX shot distribution, third-party source grading, versioning, and more. Now, when I refer to Flames media, I am not only referring to imported sources, I am also referring to any cached or rendered media you might have created in Flame. This inevitably means that the media is also most likely spread across a file system. So the Flame products have a variety of publishing tools that examine all the aspects of your media and then allows you to share your media in the most optimal way possible. Let's have a look at how Sequence Publish works. Here we have a basic example which will allow us to illustrate the publish sequence fundamentals. In this 10-second sequence, we have mostly 10-bit DPX files, a 10-bit ProRes movie file, and a blue screen shot, which is a 6K OpenEXR sequence at 16-bit. Now in this publishing scenario, we would like to send the individual shots or segments of the sequence out of Flame for additional work. In addition to this, we would also like any exported or published shots to link back into the master sequence, and this allows you to carry on working, as well as retain the timeline while finishing in Flame. So your starting point for accessing the publishing tools is to switch to the Media Hub. In the file browser, navigate to a folder where you'd like all the media to be shared, as well as possibly build a user-friendly folder structure. Now I want to make the point that this location is on the same file system as all my media. This includes the source media, as well as the Flame media folder containing any cache and renders created in Flame. Technically, all the media is scattered in different locations. So it's easier to have all the media arranged in one location, and people can go here to access the published media from Flame. Now we'll discuss the various media linking and sharing later on in the advanced publishing options. For now, select the sequence in question in the media panel and drag it into the file browser. The media export window appears, and there are some options to choose from. If you're just performing a straightforward flat export, for example, you are pushing out your final deliverables, you can export a movie file, an image sequence, or an audio file. You choose your settings, and this should be like any other standard export you've ever used. But in order to share the media of the selected sequence clip, you choose Sequence Publish. This is a more intelligent but sophisticated kind of export. Firstly, I just want to highlight all the presets. As you can see, there are a ton of combinations you can choose from to match your requirements. These can all be customized further, but they have been optimized to give you the best output. To name a few scenarios, you can round trip to Media Composer, Pro Tools, Resolve, and Final Cut Pro 10 using AAFs or XMLs. If you just want to push out an EDL with image sequences that is not application specific, you also have four EDL options to choose from which vary the media format. Finally, if you just want to publish out the individual media without exporting an AAF, XML or EDL sequence, you can choose between the shot publish, the simple publish, or the source media publish options. So what's the difference between them? Well, to keep it short, the source media publish exports the original source media of the sequence, and you can totally customize the folder or directory structure. Typical uses of these settings include source media consolidation, source media grading, and source media VFX shot distribution. The simple publish outputs all the media from the sequence with any VFX work already baked into the segments. This results in a flattened sequence, but with all the editorial cuts still defined. The typical use of these settings is outputting final shots for grading that can still be linked back into the master sequence. Finally, The shot publish is very similar to the source media publish because it also exports the source media. However, these presets use more metadata from the sequence to better name and arrange the media to be used in a VFX pipeline scenario. All these presets come from the same set of menus, and just by customizing one or two options, can create brand new publishing workflows from the Flame products. So if none of these presets work for you, you can always customize one and save it to the presets list. Now I want to focus mainly on the media publishing functionality. This will help clarify all the underlying sequence publish processes, which ultimately tie into every one of these presets. So go ahead and choose the source media publish, 10-bit DPX and WAV option. Click Show Advanced Options. The Sequence Options tab defines what will be published. This preset is just publishing the source media, so the format is set to media only. Looking in the pull-down menu, you could export the media with an EDL, AAF or XML, and that would open up your workflow to round-tripping with third-party applications. Since we're only exporting the source media, we'll leave this option set to media only. The text boxes below are empty because they are reserved for the EDL, AAF or XML export. Now, what is really important is export video and audio options. These options control what type of media you're going to share with the publish. For example, the video format indicates whether you want to output file sequences or movie files. The media pull-down menu lets you choose between using the original media, or you can use media with any VFX already baked in. For tracks and transitions, Keep All Tracks will maintain the original structure of the sequence, but the other two options will alter the structure of the sequence. Flattened Tracks allows you to force the entire sequence into a flattened single clip. Or Flattened Tracks with Transitions will flatten all the visible images into a single track and maintain the basic editorial structure. We'll use all the media and keep all the tracks. Finally, you can include extra frame handles as part of the publish. This allows you to slip or trim the edit using any published media in or out of Flame. Now, the audio media uses similar options to the video media, and you can also choose to export both or just video or audio. I know this sequence is video only, so we'll disable the export audio media. Now, because we are exporting file sequences, the Movie Options tab is grayed out. Moving down the line, the Video Options tab gives you the settings for the video media, any color management settings, and finally, the location of the published media. The file location can be manually entered, or you can use the Flame naming tokens to define a path based on specific metadata within the project. All file paths within these menus are saved as part of a preset and can be customized when required. The other major point to mention in the video options is that you can decide how to best manage your media in the publishing process. In other words, you can instruct Flame how to export and generate new media for every frame of the published sequence. Now, there's nothing wrong with this approach, but if the media already exists on the current file system as the source media, or even cached or rendered media, regenerating the same media is not great as a space-saving exercise, and it's also slow exporting a new file per frame. In all honesty, this would not suit a long-form project by having to generate brand new media just to share the same media out of Flame. So an alternative means of limiting media duplication on the same file system is that you can link to the original media instead of duplicating it. Now, when I refer to linking, I am talking about a hard link at the file system level. For example, you can have one set of data on a disk, but you can have multiple pointers referencing the same set of data. So through the publishing process, you can link to the source material, cache, and renders over the same file system and reference all that data in the published directory structure. This means the publish process should be faster because you're just generating links rather than writing new media to disk. And the bigger benefit is that because you are not duplicating media, you are not unnecessarily wasting disk space. So file linking can definitely have an advantage in various post-production scenarios. Now there are a few linking options in the menu which need to be clarified. Link media simply links to all the files, irrespective of their bit depths, resolutions, or compressions. When it comes to file formats, if the source media matches the selected format, such as DPX in this case, it will just link to the file. However, if the format is different to the chosen one, Flame will automatically generate new media for that particular source media. So it's possible to land up with a file sequence using multiple resolutions. Say, for instance, using 4K in an HD BFX segment. Flame can handle that, but not many third-party applications. So the other link options can allow you to standardize the resolution of the media using various criteria. If the media in question does not match the standard resolution of the file sequence, Flame will generate new media for those files and link to the remaining media that match the settings. Think of it as different levels of strictness when it comes to linking to media. What I think is imperative to know is that media linking is limited to file sequences. So if you're working with a movie file format, you'll be able to publish, but the linking options will not be available. Finally, switch over to the Clip Options tab. Most of this menu deals with the Open Clip workflow. We won't cover the Open Clip in this video, but it opens a whole new world with faster versioning, version tracking, and a powerful VFX collaboration pipeline using multiple applications. However, the button I do want to point out is Copy Exported Clip into Media Library. Once the original sequence has been published with all its media, Flame will rebuild the sequence as a new clip and link all the published media to the segments of this sequence. This only happens when this button is enabled. In the context of a production, it's a consolidation of all your media into a structured system. And if you overwrite that media with a new version, like a final grade for instance, this will automatically update into the newly created sequence. It's also worth noting that the original sequence will still be kept. So that is a detailed explanation behind the fundamentals of publishing a sequence. Obviously, it's worth seeing it work for real. So you can enable the foreground export and press the export button. When the publishing sequence window appears, you get a status update as each segment is published to the designated directories or folders. Now, while this is running, I just want to mention that we are publishing a single sequence. But for those of you using the Connected Conform workflow, you can publish the sources sequence for the same structured output, and then you would unlink and relink to update the sources in all the connected sequences. So the publish has now completed, and looking in the file browser, you should see a folder with the name of the sequence. Going into the directory, you will see that every segment from the sequence has its own folder, and going into any folder will reveal the predefined structure, and finally the image sequence for the media. Go back up to the root folder for the published sequence and click Scan Subdirectories. This will reveal all the clips buried within the directory structure. When you call up the preview window and select any of the media, all the media will now be 10-bit and DPX files. Any pre-existing DPX media would have been linked instead of duplicated, and the QuickTime movie, as well as the OpenEXR sequence, has been standardized into DPX files as well. So you can define your media, as well as create a structure to match your facility's pipeline through the sequence publish. In the media panel, you'll note a new clip using the same name as the original sequence, but publish has been added onto the end of the name. Switching to the timeline view and looking at the published clip, you will note that it has the same structure as the original sequence. Looking closely at all the segments, they are now all tagged as DPX media, and if you alt-click on any segment, you will see that the media is being sourced from the published media. So not only have you published out the source media into a manageable file structure, all of Flame's cached and rendered media is also accessible through a clean and logic structure. In terms of doing any basic versioning, if you were to overwrite this media externally, the segments would update the next time you scrub the media. As a bit of extra information, if the original media was cached, you would need to flush the source's cache in order to see the updated media in the sequence. Now here are a few finishing points. Please be aware that when you start using batch effect segments in the sequence, you may or may not retain the source timecode of the segment's original media. If you create a batch effects from a single segment, the source timecode is passed onto the BFX container segment. But if you create a BFX from a selection of segments on a multi-track sequence, Flame does not know what timecode to use, so it will default to the record timecode. This will be reflected in the publish media's timecode if you publish the sequence. Finally, sequence publish is extremely powerful for any production pipeline, regardless if you're a large or small facility. We've tried to provide you with as many presets, but you may want to tweak the settings until you get exactly what you're after. I hope this video on sharing media with Sequence Publish has been informative. Please be sure to check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.